Hello friends, I'm Vikram Dewan, head of the digital team at Consumer Voice, a leading NGO based in New Delhi. And I have with me today Mr. Gopal Ravi Kumar, who is the head of the Business Financial Help Desk at Consumer Voice. Welcome, Mr. Gopal Ravi Kumar.
Thank you.
So, Mr. Gopal Ravi Kumar, can you tell our consumers, our viewers about the changes to the income tax provisions for the new financial year?
Yes. The income tax provisions for this year, ending March 2019, I'll be discussing some of the important provisions which are applicable to salaried individuals. Number one is the standard deduction, which is now introduced. This was done about 5 to 6 years before it was there. Then the government withdrew it. This standard deduction is given now to 40,000 rupees per year, and this is replacing the earlier transportation allowance, that what is called conveyance allowance, and the reimbursement of medical expenses. So this will benefit a lot of salaried individuals this year.
And are there any changes regarding the senior citizens?
Yes. There are about 2-3 provisions. One is the interest on deposits. Earlier, interest on deposits in the nature of savings bank account under section TTA has been given up to 10,000 rupees per year. Now this section has been amended by introduction of another section TTB, where they have increased the amount to 50,000 rupees, including bank fixed deposits, post office fixed deposits, post office saving bank interest, bank accounts interest.
Health is a primary concern for senior citizens. So are there any changes related to this regarding medical treatment of the senior citizens?
Yes. Under section DDB, there was some amount which were given as exemption towards the medical expenses. And now this has been increased to 80,000. Earlier it was 60,000. It is for all categories of senior citizens. Now they have made a differentiation to 60,000 per year for those up to the age of 60 to 80, and 80,000 for those above 80 years of age. So another is the Mediclaim allowance, which is to be deducted directly from your gross total income under section 80D. This 80D was earlier given for 30,000 rupees, and a separate 5,000 rupees was given as a medical checkup expenses. Now they have increased it to 50,000 rupees per year. Besides this, actual medical expenditure involved will also be eligible for tax deduction.
And Mr. Gopal Ravi Kumar, are there any changes to the provision related to National Pension Scheme also?
Yes. Earlier, NPS, National Pension Scheme, was a scheme benefiting people up to 60 years of age for salaried individuals, where an additional income, additional investment of 50,000 rupees per year was given. Besides ATC, that means a man can save 1,50,000 in ATC and another 50,000 NPS, totaling to 2 lakh rupees of exemptions. Now, in the earlier scheme, the NPS was on a concept of exempt and taxable, which means that at the time of investment, the amount invested is eligible for tax deduction. At the time of final payment, the income tax was exempt. But when you want to withdraw after some period, the amount was to be included in your taxable income. Now this year they have given an exemption up to 12%, which means 60% of the amount which you draw 20% of that amount will be eligible for tax exemption. This will be very beneficial for all the salaried individuals. There is another one. The last one for the senior citizen is that they were to be part of people eligible for advance tax. This year onwards, senior citizens are exempted from payment of advance tax. So if they have no other income other than pension, they will be eligible for the exemption on payment of senior citizens advance tax. So these are the important provisions.
Well, that is very wonderful, and you have actually inspired me to start saving starting today. And I'm sure that it would be of great benefit to our consumers as well. So thank you, Mr. Kumar.
Thank you.
For coming here and talking to us.
Thank you.
Keep watching us for more such videos. Thank you.